tremendous this evening as the VNA commemorate the 150th anniversary of the Battle of Magdala at a time when Ethiopians at home and abroad observe with a great sense of patriotism the 20th birthday of Emperor Tewodros II of Ethiopia, and of course the 150th anniversary of his death. Our Minister of Culture and Tourism had very much hoped to join us this evening, but due to unforeseen circumstances, she has been obliged to send her regrets. I shall therefore be echoing in my short speech her sentiments and indeed those of my government. This evening's function comes at a time when UK-Ethiopia relations are at an all-time high. In our centuries of relations, the Battle of Magdala and its aftermath constitute a deeply sad episode in our shared story. However, I take comfort from what Dr. Hunt recently stated publicly about the prospect of loaning Ethiopia some of the Magdala artifacts. In fact, I wish to avail myself of this occasion to call on other custodians of Magdala treasures in the UK to follow the trail being blazed by the VNA in publicly showcasing these historic artifacts. It's only in sharing this cultural heritage with the public at large that we can acknowledge and learn from our shared history. For Ethiopians, tonight is a significant first step towards the eventual return of these treasures home. In fact, there is a glorious precedent which can be used as a source of inspiration, not only to the VNA, but to all museums who house other Magdala artifacts. It is with a sense of gratitude and appreciation that Ethiopia has acknowledged the goodwill gesture of two British monarchs who returned priceless items taken away at Magdala. In 1924, during the state visit to the UK by the then regent and later emperor, Haile Selassie, King George V handed over the coronation crown of Emperor Theodros to Emperor Haile Selassie. 41 years later, in 1965, Her Majesty the Queen followed in her father's footsteps and handed over to Emperor Haile Selassie yet another of Emperor Theodros' crowns while on a state visit to Ethiopia. Even the Napier family, themselves, have recently returned a necklace and some scrolls to the Institute of Ethiopian Studies in Addis Ababa. yet further proof that times change, and so do attitudes. Today, encouraged by Dr. Hunt's sentiments, we hope other custodians of Magdala artifacts will now follow in the footsteps of the Napier family, King George V and Her Majesty the Queen Elizabeth II. Once again, I wish to thank Dr. Hunt and the V&A for their supreme efforts in bringing together this fascinating exhibition, which we hope will bring about greater understanding of our cultural heritage and greater cooperation going forward. Thank you for your attention and enjoy the exhibition. Thank you.